Good morning, Colfax, and welcome to CTV for September 25th. I'm Mary O'Rourke, and I'm joined by Megan Towne. Today, we will turn our attention to our own health and wellness.
We do a little cooking with Katie.
And get you caught up on students' life with our segment, Did You Know?
Welcome to the show.
Thanks, guys. Damn, that's pretty cool. Here, check it out.
Slowly but surely, our students and staff are figuring out not only how to deliver a quality education, but also connect beyond the classroom. Senior leaders Faith Mora, Sophie Wolf, and Leah Reese hosted the annual Club Rush this week, and to their surprise, the energy was great.
All right, guys, welcome to WAO. Today, we're gonna go over some of our club objectives and goals for this year. We're gonna have to adjust a little bit due to the
One highlight from Club Rush this year is that we've got 14 clubs to participate.
A highlight for me from Club Rush this year was that we got a lot of video submissions from clubs introducing their club, and they're really great videos from advisors and club leaders. I think they made a lot of people want to join their clubs.
Lastly, Club Rush 2020 was just an idea, and I'm really proud of how far it's become with all the advisors wanting to participate, students wanting to participate, students wanting to create new clubs still, even though it's only virtual Club Rush. So if you haven't been able to go check out Club Rush, make sure you check your emails for the website. All the Google Meet codes are on that website. And if you miss anything, all the contact information will be on that website as well.
I have personally attended the Women's Athletic Organization meeting and experienced the excited spirit everyone felt towards an exciting year ahead. Clubs will press on all semester long, and more clubs will be added depending on how the reopening progresses. If you do not have a chance to make a Club Rush meeting yet, meetings will continue next week, and leadership will be sending out a roster with club leaders so you can get on their email list.
I have all the faith that clubs will thrive, because when passionate people connect over a common interest, good things happen. And speaking of good things, the Evergreen Yearbook team has been working behind the scenes preparing to publish what will certainly be the most unique yearbook in high school history.
We have a small but enthusiastic group of students from freshman to senior who are determined to document this once-in-a-lifetime year. They're currently coming up with unique coverage themes and are going to be reaching out to you, the student body, to tell your stories. One of my early favorites is Me and My Pet. So get your pets ready for prime time, and remember, you have to be in the picture too. The yearbook team will publish the best submissions, and there will be new themes nearly every week. The Evergreen team wants anybody and everybody to submit images to tell the story of this year.
I got a little sneak peek at some of the pages, and you will be happy to know every student's picture will be featured by class, a traditional favorite. Senior superlatives will once again grace the pages, and so much more.
The yearbook is going on sale today at an all-time low of $59.99, and you can get a 10% discount until September 30th. This includes two full pages that you get to design for your own book, as well as 100 additional pages that will capture this year. Go to the CHS website to purchase your book today.
Keeping your mind and body right during stressful times is critical for all of us, and Leadership's Maddie Preston and Lean Green want to help all Colfax students to embrace their health while having fun.
The COVID-19 shutdown brought many changes to everyday lives. The routines we had formed daily, like school and work, were completely flipped upside down. But almost as importantly, the exercise we had all grown accustomed to through sports and gym use ended abruptly. People had to figure out different ways to get exercise than they normally do, which is exactly what leadership had in mind when leadership member and project chair Maddie Preston chose to launch a health and wellness campaign at Colfax High School.
I just think it's really important for people to stay active when we're in such like a hard time, and I feel like it's really important that people like know that there's other things to do besides sitting on your phone all day. You could go on a hike, make a recipe, do something fun with your time that's also good for you.
The health and wellness campaign is aimed towards getting students out in their community to experience healthy activities like hiking and water sports. With the many natural resources in our area, from beautiful trails to abundant lakes and rivers, getting out to exercise can be easy. Leadership wants to inspire people to do these activities as often as they can, to not only show the mental and physical health benefits, but also show how fun it can be. Donna Bussinger, the Colfax High School health teacher, shared about the mental and physical benefits.
So obviously the physical benefits are you gain body strength, you gain, you know, it helps with your body composition, and it just gives you energy. You feel good, it helps you to sleep better at night. And the mental benefits, you know, again, are amazing because, it helps you to sleep at night when you're getting physical exercise during the day. It helps lower anxiety, which I'm sure a lot of people are feeling with, you know, with everything that's been going on this past year. So it helps reduce your anxiety. And if there's a way to safely exercise with a friend, even if it's just a hike on a trail, it's a beautiful way to enhance your social, you know, since we are having to distance ourselves. But if you're able to do that safely, it's a great way to just get outside, enjoy nature, and have, you know, the benefits of having somebody with you to talk with.
In addition to the benefits to your emotional and physical state, participating in active outdoor activities can be extremely fun. Ava Dunleavy, a sophomore and avid lake sport enthusiast, is all about getting on the water.
My favorite activities to do on the lake is single seeing and wakeboarding.
One of the best things about recreational activities like those being promoted is how varied they are. You can easily go on a hike close to your home, or if you prefer, try a water sport like swimming, boating, or kayaking. Each activity is different, so no matter what, you can always find what works for you.
What got me into single skiing and wakeboarding is my mom. She's been driving the boat for 20 years and she competition skied and just taught me how to do it when I was 12, and I've been doing it ever since.
To spread awareness, Leadership intends to reach out over Instagram to share favorite recreational areas, healthy snacks, fun exercises, and so much more. Keep an eye out for posts to follow this great campaign and share your stories of health and wellness with them while having fun. Remember, never be afraid to expand your horizons because you might just find a new favorite activity.
Okay, I'm in. I see some lake time this weekend for me. What about you, Megan?
I'm all about the lake, but this weekend, I think I'm gonna tackle the trails.
Good plan. We are kicking off a new segment this week called Did You Know? CTV has had our ear to the ground and wanted to make sure we are keeping you in the know about things happening on campus. So here's Chelan Ackerman with Did You Know?
Good morning, Colfax. Did you know that a 30-year veteran forester was on campus last week working with engineering students to take raw logs and turn them into lumber?
Bob Suter, parent at Colfax High. His kids graduated a long time ago, active community member, retired forester, worked in the forestry trade his whole life. He's a private landowner, forester. Comes to Colfax High a few different times. He brought in a bunch of pine logs from his property. Those pine logs were loaded onto our mill, and we milled them with his expertise guiding us. We milled them into usable lumber. So Forester Suter really kind of guided the students and myself through really kind of pretty cool techniques that they use in the forestry industry and in the milling industry to turn rough cut trees into usable lumber. I mean, it is so fortunate to have such a supportive community and supportive people in our community to come to school and share their 30 years of experience with the students. I mean, Bob's been milling lumber and working in forestry his whole life, and we're just so fortunate to have him come and share that wealth of information with us. So there are a lot of techniques I learned from him, one of which was that you take the overall diameter, multiply that by 70%, and then cut that in half to figure out the size of can to the log. So he really knew how to maximize the efficiencies of lumber manufacturing. And he shared that with all of us. It's pretty interesting. I mean, I love the math, the woodworking, and most importantly, I just love seeing a waste product be turned into a useful product.
Did you know that there's an EA Sports Madden video game tournament kicking off next week? And there's more. The top two players from the Colfax tournament are going to get matched up against regional schools like Del Oro and Placer. Those games will be broadcast on Twitch TV. So while we wait for live sports to come back, we will be pulling for Colfax in the world of Madden. Check your email and sign up today. Colfax, we know there are all sorts of great things going on around campus, and we here at CTV want to let everybody know. So teachers, students, if you or your program want to be spotlighted on Did You Know, email me at ackermanc23@puhsd.k12.ca.us.
Thank you, Shelan. I definitely was not in the know. Believe it or not, if there is a good rivalry matchup in the Madden tourney, I think I'm going to have to tune in. I just miss a good rivalry game.
You and me both, Megan. I think by this point, our viewers have caught on to the health and wellness theme in this week's show. And one of the key components to good health is what we eat. Despite most teens wanting to eat healthy, the effort it takes to find the right ingredients and prepare it can give away to grabbing unhealthy, prepared foods. Reporter Katie Reynolds with Productions Director Zander Rowe took it upon themselves to provide some practical solutions for this problem. Here's Cooking with Katie.
Hi, I'm Katie Reynolds, and welcome to Cooking with Katie. So my mom's been making my lunch since kindergarten, and I'm a senior. So over quarantine, I've had to learn to feed myself. I've mastered nachos, top ramen, and mac and cheese. But today, I'm going to teach you my personal favorite, a cheesy quesadilla. So let's get right to it with the sides. Our first step is going to be getting an avocado and slicing her down the middle. Take out the pit, put it in the compost or trash. Now you slice it into the little triangles and put it in your bowl. Now we're gonna mash up the avocados. Okay, now we're gonna get our limes ready for our guac. Okay, now we're gonna squeeze in our limes. We're gonna do salt and pepper to taste. Now we're gonna move on to our salsa. So first we're gonna dice up some tomatoes. We're going to add cilantro into our tomato base. So today we're making mild salsa, but if you want to make medium heat salsa, you can add an onion. And if you want to make hot salsa, add an onion and jalapeno. Now we're going to gently combine as we add salt and pepper. Now we're going to move on to our main dish, which is a nice golden brown quesadilla. We're gonna place in our tortilla and add our cheese. Now we're gonna place on our top tortilla and let the cheese melt just a little bit more. Now it's time to slice and plate our quesadilla. I like to use a pizza cutter, but if you don't have a pizza cutter at home, you're welcome to use a knife. Overall, this is an easy recipe that you can spice up yourself, and that's how you cook with Katie.
Thank you to the entire Cooking with Katie team. I am officially hungry. That's all we have for you this week, Colfax. Next week, we will check in with some Colfax students that are navigating work during the pandemic.
Until then, I'm Mary O'Rourke for Megan Towne, and have a great day, Colfax.